Hi everyone, welcome to the classes on food machinery. Today we'll be discussing the condition for minimum work done and the minimum work done by the reciprocating compressor, that is multi-stage reciprocating compressor. So in the previous class we have already discussed the condition, that is the work done equation. Now we are going to calculate the condition for minimum work done, or the same derivation is can be used for, we'll be finding the equation for intermediate pressure. So this equation, the work done equation, we have already derived in the last class. Now we are going to apply the condition for minimum work done. So for that we will be differentiating the above equation with respect to P2, and we are equating that equal to 0. So we will be writing d by dP2 of n by n minus 1, P1 V1, P2 by P1 all raised to n minus 1, and P3 by P2 all raised to n minus 1 by n minus 2 equal to 0. So if we are differentiating with respect to P2, all other terms other than P2 will be taken as constant. So we have to differentiate only two terms, P2 by P1 and P3 by P2. Okay, and the remaining terms will be taken as constant. And for the convenience, we are writing n by n minus 1 as a single term. And we are putting n by n minus 1 equal to a constant k. So we are rewriting the equation d by dP2 of k into P1 V1, P2 by P1, all raised to k, and P3 by P2 all raised to k minus 2 equal to 0. Okay. So we will be differentiating as k P1 V1 equal to constant, we will be differentiating only P2 by P1 and P3 by P2. Okay. So I have written the same equation here, we will be differentiating the first equation. So we are taking P2 as the differential. So all other terms will be constant. So in this, the first term P2 by P1, 1 by P1 will be constant. So, we will be taken that outside. 1 by P1 raised to k into. We are going to differentiate P2 raised to k. So, P2 raised to k can be written as k into P2 raised to k minus 1. X cube can be differentiated as 3x square. Similarly, P2 raised to k can be differentiated as k2 into P2 raised to k minus 1. Plus the second term is P3 by P2 all raised to k. So in this, P3 is a constant. So we wrote P3 constant outside. And the remaining term is 1 by P2 raised to k. Or we can write P2 raised to minus k. So we are going to differentiate P2 raised to minus k. So it will be minus k into P2 raised to minus k minus 1. Okay. So our differentiation is over. Now we are going to get to 0. The constant, this is a constant. Constant cannot be 0. So remaining possibility is this will be equal to 0. So we will be writing 1 by p1 raised to k into p2 raised to k minus 1 plus p3 raised to k minus k into p2 raised to minus k minus 1 equal to 0. So we will be expanding the bracket. This positive sign will be negative and taking one term to the other side of the equality sign. So we will be rewriting the equation as k into p1 raised to minus k, that is 1 by p1 can be written as p1 raised to minus k, and p2 raised to k minus 1 equal to, will be taken the all negative terms, these terms to the right side of the equality sign. So k into minus k will become positive k, p3 raised to k same as, and p2 raised to minus k minus 1. So k and k get cancelled, and remaining term will be P1 raised to minus k and P2 raised to k minus 1, P3 raised to k and P2 raised to minus k minus 1. So, we will be taking all P2 terms together. So, we will be taking P2 terms to the left side of the equality sign and the remaining P2 and so P1 and P3 to the right side of the equality sign. So, here P2 raised to k minus 1 is there and here P2 raised to minus k minus 1 is there. So, it will go to the denominator P2 raised to minus k minus 1. And here P3 raised to k is there and P1 raised to minus k will come to the denominator. So, total will be rewriting the equation as P1 raised to k, P3 raised to k into P1 raised to k. The minus sign will be gone when it is going to the numerator. That is 1 by x raised to minus 1 equal to x. Or x raised to minus 1 equal to 1 by x. Similarly, p1 raised to minus k can be written as p1 raised to k. 1 by p1 raised to minus k is equal to p1 raised to k. Similarly, we can write p2 into k minus 1. This denominator p2 will become p2 raised to k plus 1. So, p2 raised to k minus 1 into p2 raised to k plus 1. So, total it will be p2 raised to 2k. Here, p3 raised to k, p1 raised to k. So, we will be writing in the equation p2 raised to k and p3 raised to p into p1 raised to k. So, we will be cancelling the k terms. We can write as p2 square equal to p1 into p3. Or p2 can be written as root of p1 p3. So, this is the condition for minimum work done. So, if the work done is to be minimum, the intermediate pressure should be the root of square root of the product of p1 and p3. Okay, so this is the condition for minimum work done, and this is the same derivation for the intermediate pressure. So for both you have to write this derivation. Now we are going to apply this condition for the work done. So this is our work done equation. We are going to apply our condition p2 equal to root of p1 p3 in the equation. So squaring both sides, we will get p2 square is equal to p1 p3. We will be rearranging it as p2 by p1 is equal to p3 by p2. Okay. Again, we are going to dividing the second equation. This equation is divided by p1 square. RHS and LHS is divided by p1 square. So p2 square by p1 square and p1 p3 divided by p1 square. So p1 and p1 get cancelled. Remaining will be p1 by p3. Taking the square root, p2 by p1 is equal to p3 by p1. So we can write the our equation p2 by p1 is equal to p3 by p2 and p2 by p1 is equal to p3 by p1. Okay, so substituting these values, we are substituting p2 by p1 is equal to p3 by p1. In this term is substituted and p3 by p2 is replaced by p3 by p1 all raised to 1 by 2. Okay. So, we will be rewriting the equation as p3 by p1 all raised to n minus 1 by n into 1 by 2. So, n minus 1 divided by 2n. Here also, n minus 1 by n into 1 by 2, it will become n minus 1 divided by 2n. So, this is the equation for minimum work done. This is the minimum work done for a two-stage reciprocating compressor. And p3 by p1 is a common term. So, we can write 2 into p3 by p1 minus 2. So we can take this 2 outside the bracket and we can write 2 into n minus 1 minus 1 p1 v1 p3 by p1 all raised to n minus 1 by 2n. So this term and this term can be generalized. So we can, this is the equation for the 2 stage compressor. If you are writing the equation for 3 stage compressor, instead of 2, 2 will be replaced by 3. It will be 3n by n minus 1 p1 v1 p4 by 1 n minus 1 by 3n minus 1. And we can write the general equation as for a n stage compressor, x into n divided by n minus 1 p1 v1 pressure of x plus 1th term. If it is a 2 stage compressor, we will have 3 pressure. If it is a 3 stage compressor, we will have 4 pressure. Similarly, if it is a n stage x stage compressor, it will have x plus 1 pressure. So p of x plus 1 divided by p1 all raised to n minus 1 by xn minus 1. So this is the equation for minimum work done for a two-stage reciprocating compressor. So all the three derivation will be asking for the university examination. For the 5th and 6th module, the weightage will be more for the derivation compared to the first three module. The weightage will be more given for the derivation by the university as the history of question paper. So study these and we will be discussing more problem in connection with these equations. Okay, thank you.